Barco's Control Room Management Suite is a very easy-to-install, hardware-independent software package that enables people to easily connect to information, exercise control over it, and collaborate with others in as many ways as there are conceivable environments or situations. The Control Room Management Suite creates a network-based infrastructure that turns any workstation into both a controller and a display. And not just large dedicated displays, but any operator workstation, even standard PCs and other devices. With one central server at its heart, the Control Room Management Suite creates a network to which all video and data sources link up, from which all displays acquire information and through which all workstations operate. This central server acts as the software module that controls and configures every other component of the system and stores all the information and in one central location. If we focus now on the operator workstations, we'll begin to get a clear idea as to how incredibly versatile and easy to use the Control Room Management Suite is. Because to every workstation, with several displays and control applications, we add a new piece of software that allows operators to also manipulate all the information locally, in a virtually unlimited number of ways, and all at the same time. How does this new piece of software we add to workstations work? Basically, what operators will now have at their immediate disposal is what we call the Control Room Sidebar, a very simple and intuitive interface. In it, they will be able to see immediately a list of all the information sources that are available on the network. If the list is very large, as the system can accommodate literally thousands of sources, operators can use the readily accessible search function to find any specific source. Let's say we need to locate a camera quickly. If we type in CAM in the search field, the sidebar will display all sources whose names contain these characters. In addition to this, operators can attach meta tags to sources they're particularly interested in and further simplify the search process. Now they can, if they want, preview a source by just clicking on it, like this, before adding it to an existing or a newly created perspective. A perspective is a selection of information sources laid out in a certain pattern, configured to behave in certain ways, and that can be displayed on its own or in combination with other perspectives. Since the control sidebar makes the creation and management of display perspectives a very easy process, let's simply create a new one from scratch. First, we click on the Perspectives tab. Here, operators will see a list of all the existing perspectives, but since we have decided to create a new one, let's click on Create New Perspective. As you can see, what we have now created is what would equate to a blank canvas. It's on this canvas that we will now create and later manage our new perspective. Say we want to include the camera source we had searched for just a minute ago. All we have to do is click on the Sources tag to go back to the list and drag the source with our mouse onto the perspective, our blank canvas. There it is. If we, of course, decide that it's too small, we can easily resize it like this. And if we prefer to have it in a different area of the perspective, we can simply move it. There. That's better. Let's now add another source to this perspective. We can search for CNN's weather website, for example. Okay, there it is. Let's drag it into our perspective and resize and position it to our satisfaction. That's pretty good. And now, let's add this weather radar data source. If we need to lay out the sources really fast, or simply prefer not to have to do it manually, we can use the tiling button and choose from the many automatic source positioning options like 2x2 for 4 sources, 3x3 for 9 sources, and so on. If we click on 2x2 now for our 3 sources, each source is resized and positioned automatically. If we now add a fourth source, say this other radar image, you can see how it snaps into the free slot in our tiling. As you've seen, within seconds, we've created a new perspective, a very simple example indeed with just 4 sources, but you can extrapolate from it how easy it would be to create one that would contain as many sources as you would require. Now we can use this simple perspective to illustrate some of the other capabilities of the system. Let's take a look at what we call decorators. Decorators allow the metadata that every source contains, such as name, status, and so on, to be displayed in the perspective automatically. For example, this live video feed from a CCTV camera at an airport does not tell us as much as we may need to know. Is this camera's view field pointing toward the north? The west? This could be essential information if we were monitoring potential disruption created by a weather system approaching from a certain direction. Or, to give another example, in a security surveillance scenario, the direction toward which intruders may be heading. So what we would now do is click on the Decorators tab of our control room sidebar and immediately access a list of the different decorators that can be displayed in this source. Let's choose this decorator. And there it is. Now everyone will know where exactly the events displayed on this video source are taking place. Other decorators can be, for instance, alarm borders that, if all is well, would be, say, green. But that should specific IF scenarios occur, such as motion detectors being triggered, would turn red and, if you want, flash intermittently, immediately directing people's attention to the events being displayed. Decorators can be easily created and customized to show precisely what we need and behave in exactly the manner we need them to. Since we now have a very basic perspective that displays the sources we've chosen and their respective decorators, we can move ahead to the next step. Let's share this perspective with others. Here, above the perspective, we find the Share button. If we click it, we can choose the different displays and/or workstations with which we can share this perspective. Let's choose, for example, this large display here. Now, if we click on Displays in our control sidebar, we can view what this particular display is showing. There it is. And yes, our little perspective has been added to that display. And as you can see, other perspectives that were created and are controlled by us or other operators are also showing. If, like it seems here, the layout of the different perspectives is somewhat disorganized or could simply be organized in a more efficient layout, we can click on Tiling, just as we did when we were creating our perspective, and choose the most appropriate layout. In this case, a tiling consisting of one large perspective in the center of the display with the other perspective neatly laid out around it is best. So there it is. And this will allow the different users to automatically select what perspective is to be shown larger at the center of the display. Now, if a second operator is monitoring how the same weather system is affecting a different location, for which purpose she has created a perspective with these two sources, both would be able to see each other's perspectives on the large display wall. And even though for obvious reasons they would not be able to modify the other's perspective, both could collaborate in the creation of a third perspective that would combine sources from both individual perspectives. The large display would then show this. Here's the new perspective they've created. And once they're satisfied with it, they would forward it to, say, the different local crisis management centers that are likely to be affected by the same weather system. For instance, where the officials in charge could set in motion whatever measures they deem necessary. From this extremely basic example of the control room management suite's power to easily allow people to connect to information, exercise control over it, and collaborate with others, you can now imagine how easily and efficiently it will adapt to all environments and situations. In fact, what the control room management suite creates is the most flexible control room instrument within an environment that can not only fulfill all your present needs, but that will easily and quickly grow and adapt as those needs evolve. In today's world, and in preparation for tomorrow's, connect, control, and collaborate.